Now, being a journalist can get you jailed or even killed in many countries. Two new reports released ahead of the United Nations Press Freedom Day on Tuesday, May the 3rd, say the media are facing greater pressure and more danger than in the past. VOA senior investigative analyst Jeffrey Young tells us female journalists can face even greater challenges.
Two new reports from the NGOs Freedom House and the Committee to Protect Journalists say reporters are increasingly threatened by physical danger, harsh anti-press laws, or by force in many countries to avoid challenging governments or radical movements. The Freedom House report, titled The Battle for the Dominant Message, says news agencies presenting balanced reporting face stiff competition from other media outlets designed specifically to promote a political or radical religious agenda. It says the media environment in a growing number of countries is characterized by partisanship and polarization. The CPJ report, titled Attacks on the Press, spotlights the additional challenge a reporter faces if she is a woman. Here's CPJ's Dr. Courtney Redge.
Women face specific threats, specific types of violence, which is often sexualized, and they face this type of violence both offline in the physical world, sexual assaults, discrimination at work, difficulty in getting assignments, and they face this online through trolling, sexualized harassment online.
North Korea tops Freedom House's 2015 Not Free list. Turkmenistan and Uzbekistan are second and third. Eritrea is fifth and Equatorial Guinea eighth. More journalists are being killed. The CPJ reports 10 journalists have died since the beginning of this year. And these victims are not only war correspondents. Freedom House says writing about corruption, organized crime, religion, and environmental or land development issues can get reporters arrested or harmed. Syria led the world last year in the number of journalists killed, with 14. The Charlie Hebdo massacre of eight cartoonists and editors in Paris pushed France into the number two spot. The East African state of Eritrea is rated the most censored country. North Korea and Saudi Arabia are second and third, with Ethiopia fourth. CPJ's Courtney Radz.
So Eritrea and Ethiopia top the list because they have the most journalists in prison out of all countries in Africa. They restrict the internet. They have limited independent press. In fact, essentially no press.
The rest of the top 10 most censored list include Azerbaijan, Vietnam, Iran, China, Myanmar, Burma, and Cuba. China has the dubious honor of having the most journalists behind bars. Sub-Saharan Africa presented a mixed picture in 2015. On the bright side, Burkina Faso decriminalized libel. Ivory Coast's private media market expanded, and there were fewer attacks on those outlets. Togo opened up its media to opposition candidates in 2015, but at the same time, reintroduced prison terms for disseminating what authorities call false news. On the negative side, Freedom House says Ghana, previously the only country in Africa deemed free for media, dropped to partly free. In Burundi, last May's political crisis resulted in the shutdown of nearly all independent media. Kenya increased media pressure through new repressive laws and other intimidation. In Tanzania, two new laws strengthen restrictions on reporters. Freedom House's report lists nine countries to watch in 2016. Three are in Africa. In Egypt, we may be seeing the emergence of more critical reporting, but there are also indications of increasing moves by the state to enforce conformity. Zimbabwe is being monitored as the ruling party sorts out the question of who will succeed President Robert Mugabe. And Ghana appears to be increasing pressure on media in advance of elections later this year.